Sorry guys, let's continue. I think my Zoom here is misbehaving. I haven't upgraded, but I'll upgrade in the next session. I didn't have enough time. I would have kept you guys waiting. So bear with me, but let's continue. We'll have another 40 or 30 minutes to talk more on sentiment analysis. So, hello. Okay, yes. I'll talk to you later. Okay. So just a minute, guys. Yeah, we are back. So let's continue. So I was talking, I was on sentiment. So let me share my screen.
Hello.
Yes. Welcome, Joy. Welcome. So let me share my screen again. So we are back. So I was talking about sentiment. So how do you visualize sentiment, or how are you able to know sentiment and how it operates? So for sentiment, basically we'll be using more of moving average 200. So this is momentum. So let me put 200 MA. So moving average, okay, this is period 200. So let me put 200 and then say, okay. Oh, sorry, this is momentum. Delete indicator window. So let me add up moving average from here. Yeah, I think this is okay. Moving average, let me give it color blue, period 200. So I'm using simple, but it's because simple is able to track future price action. So then I say, okay, so that's my moving average. So let's look at price. So you can see it's not very visible on monthly. So let me go to weekly, because you can see now it's been trending on a downward trend. So that's why I was telling you the dollar mostly has been weakening. So let me use the weekly chart. Yeah, this is the weekly chart. Then I'm going to zoom out completely. So this has been my dollar. So you can see this is sentiment. So moving average, you can see these are my levels of as resistance, because this has been a very strong downtrend. So there's one level here, there's another level here, there's another level here. So as at the moment, it's still really, really been rallying, going down. So and I'm not sure, let me use the line chart so that because basically, as I'm telling you, for me, I'm visualizing, or I'm trying to understand what really moves the market. So for the dollar this year, the big major move, of course, was the cutting of the interest rates. We saw that the dollar lost, how much did we see? Let's calculate. So it's good to always calculate so that you're able to know what you're dealing with. So let's go back and see the dollar index. So 1 minute, guys. So let's check the dollar index again, because we need to understand the sentiment behind what really moves it. So we have more time now, because now we are more on practical. I was done with the theory on that part one. So on this second session, let's now understand what moved. So I was showing you the USDX. So when you're dealing with the USDX, so you're dealing basically with, when you're dealing with USDX here, you're dealing basically with the dollar index. So the whole, you use dollars. Okay, if you don't use dollars, but at least you know the dollars. We are talking of the United States of America. It's usually the world economy, number one. Their military is good. Politically, they are more stable. They have democracy. And there are so many factors. Of course, the US dollar is also used as the world reserve currency. Most businesses internationally are also transacted using the US dollar. So the US dollar is usually one of the most important currencies we pay much attention, or we pay so much close attention to, while basically understanding sentiment. So the big major move on sentiment analysis, number one, was the cutting of the interest rate. This was around March 20th. So you can also check. So let's go back to our calendar so that we can confirm the date when the interest rates were cut. So let me use this. So just a minute, guys, so that we can be able to understand when exactly. So you also need to always keep track of the dates on when. So I was trying to buy the Zoom, but I'll buy it later. So guys, let me go to minute. So yeah, let me go to the economic calendar. So we use Forex Factory. Oh, guys are still coming in. Welcome, guys. Sorry for the last mishap, but we are working to have at least an hour. So give me guys time. I'm working to have at least 1 good hour or 1.5 with you guys online. So I hope you can bear with me for today, but at least we have an extra half an hour or so. So you can be asking questions as I continue. So you can be asking questions. So let's go to Forex Factory. Forexfactory.com. Mm-hmm. So just a minute. So here is Forex Factory. So it's right here. So minute. So sorry. Kindly mute, guys, mute your microphones, or let me mute them. Because I think guys can't hear. So let me mute, guys. Mute all. Yeah, I think that's better. So mute all. Okay. So let's continue, guys. So as I was saying, sentiment, we are on the dollar and what happened, or we are trying to track what has been happening to the dollar, at least the better part of this year, and the better part of, you know, its history, how far it's gone and stuff like that. So let me go to, this is my calendar. I usually use it it's usually good and very important, the economic calendar. So just 1 minute, guys. Let me load it. It's loading. So these are the interest rates. So here they are. So my main focus is on the, yeah, here we are here on the USD. So check on the USD, guys. So they were able to cut the interest rates as -1.00%. So I'm also going to pull out the chart. So let's go to the graph. Can you see, guys? There's a graph here. Now, this graph that I'm going to pull out, we are basically seeing how the US economy or what the dollar has been doing. So let's wait. So they will cut it on. So I just wanted us to check the date. It was exactly on March 16th. So you can see it was exactly on March 16th. So March 16th, they cut the rates by -1.0%. So as at the moment, they were almost near zero. So they're not greater, they are greater than zero, 0.25%. So March 16th, we go back to our chart. So what happened on March 16th? So this is our chart on March 16th on the USD index. So March 16th. So this was, we need to check the dates down here. So this was exactly, yes, you can see it was exactly March 16th. This was March 15th, the big blue candle. Let me zoom in. So guys, you can see. So this was March 15th, this candle. Then March 16th, between 15th and now, the next day, there was a big, big, big bear candle. This was almost exactly 549 pips. You can imagine, just for them cutting the interest rate alone, the dollar fell by 549 pips. This is purely sentiment. I did not even need to check my fundamental. It was outright. They cut the rates, the dollar had to lose, and it lost 549 pips. Then there was a bull candle, bear candle. So this was the consolidation, because what the market does after this kind of move, it went up and down, it has to consolidate. When it's consolidating, the way you're seeing, there's a bull candle, there's a bear candle, there's a doji, there's an inverted. So what it's doing, it's looking for another direction. But the impact was this. So you can see now there is usually the aftermath. Or basically, if something happened. For example, like when Hiroshima was hit, there was the aftermath. 10 years later, there were cancerous cases. And basically, it took almost 20 years for them to recover after that bombing that happened then. So there is usually the aftermath. If there is COVID is hitting us, there will be an aftermath. Aftermath is, of course, we have deaths, guys been, you know, dying and all. There we have recoveries, that's the aftermath. And we also have businesses shutting down, and we know what has been happening, more people indoors, we are live now. Most of this training, I was conducting them on, you know, one-on-one, I can't, but now we have to use Zoom. Zoom, of course, was the big beneficiary when COVID hit this year. So they had to cut the rates, because they didn't cut the rates, businesses were failing. So let me give you this fundamental outlook and why basically the central bank or the Federal Reserve had to cut the interest rates. Businesses were failing. I think the unemployment rates hit up to 52 million. At least the last NFP report was good. There was 1.2 million jobs created, but that's still not good enough, because you can imagine 52 million people out there, they're unemployed. They need a salary, they need money, they need utilities, basic needs and all that. The government had to pull out an extra 2 trillion again. That was from nowhere, to be able to give them a $600 check every month, basically to help them sustain themselves and their families. So you can see how fundamental, or how fundamental affects sentiment. So the sentiment after they cut the rates from this area here, the dollar again lost up to 700, let's say between where it is right now, this is 728 pips. So you can imagine from when they cut the rates, there was a little consolidation. So what you do, me, I would have sold immediately when that report came out or that news came out. And then I would have waited. The one I usually am interested in is the aftermath. So the aftermath is this one, 724 pips. So, and I really do, I don't think it's coming back sooner. But now what I've done, I have drawn my area of my zone, my area of support, this zone here. So this price, it either has to break this red line or has to bounce. So if it breaks, I'll be going up. If it doesn't break, bounces back, will this most likely be a pullback? So when the pullback means it will pull back a little bit above, then keep going down. So the main guy that will be guiding me will be this CCI and this RSI. So you can see right now, my market is on an oversold condition. So our class tomorrow will be on oscillators for those guys who will be coming. So I'll be explaining more overbought and oversold condition, but that mostly is under technical. But sentiment speaking, we are at an oversold condition, because you can see right now, the dollar since, this is weekly chart. So since January, so this was January when we started. So the dollar at least had gained a little 330 sentiment speaking. Then what happened next? It lost again. This was 477. And then now it gained again. You can see the moving average 200 again. It gained again 789. So this is the USD index. Then now it lost. So let's see how much it lost up to now. It has lost almost 1,040 pips. So yeah, I can see some questions. So let's see if we can answer them as we continue. So there are sentiments that are due for another financial recession in the cycle, though COVID has had some recession impact, so maybe later. Yeah, sure. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Yeah, that's very true. So Forex Factory, same as Forex Calendar, can be found on App Store. Yeah, so for Forex Factory, just check it. It's our website, forexfactory.com. You can also check investing.com. Those are the two main calendars I use to check the economic calendar, because they have very good news, and those news come, like very, very fast, because you always need to have the news exactly when it was released. So forexfactory.com, so that's the website. Or investing.com. So you can either use. So for the dollar, because I've told you, this is our main guy for this year, because we are looking at an electioneering year, and elections are sometimes can be very pretty nasty. We have seen what they have done even in our country. You know, there are two people, very strong, very powerful. All of them are loaded. Everyone wants to lead. You have over 100 million people who are going to vote. We have no idea. Sentimentally speaking, I'll be honest with you, with all the experience I have with an election, you have no idea who will win until the final tally. So the polls can come out, but people can change their mind the last minute. So it's an individual decision. God gave us free will. Everyone can choose. So when you come to an election, that is usually the most difficult. Like when we did Brexit, let's go back to the pound. and then I show you what really happened. I'm going to use the weekly chart. So let me go back to the pound. So for the dollar, right now we are at an over. This is an oversold condition where we are, because you have seen it has lost over 140 pips, 1,000, not 100, 1,000. Remember, I need you guys to check. I'm using weekly time frame, because weekly time frame, I need to track the trend. The way you can see this trend is moving, I am tracking it. And the only way I'm tracking it is using support and resistance and moving average 200, simple, because I'm trying to check the future price action of what or where this price will be. So, and this price has to be, there has to be a catalyst. If the price will have to go up, there has to be a catalyst. So the news and the fundamentals, they play a very, very big role for me to know. So right now, as at the dollar, I'm still waiting. When I go back to pound, let me go back to pound again. So pound USD, that's the cable. So cable right now, you can see it has crossed the 200. Let me use the candlesticks. So because the line chart basically is the sentiment. So you can see line chart can be able. So for you to have an overview of sentiment, I'll advise you at least to use the line chart. So when you're using a line chart, let me zoom out. So this is the cable on weekly since 2003, since 21st, 2003. What you're looking at a zone whereby you get a V or a W, or you'll get an M up here, so that you can be able to know how far the sentiment will be. But when you're using, I think I have another question. Let me check. Sentiments, DT is coming back, but Joe Biden is also a very strong opponent with a good choice of running mate. Yeah, most likely. I'm also on Trump might, so, but it's an election. So for elections, I don't know. We just wait. I'm still, okay, I'm for Trump, but the idea with Trump is good economically, but it's a difficult election. So for me, this one, I don't have any say. So I'll just have to wait so that we can be able to see the outcome of this election. So let's go back to cable. Let me use the candlesticks, because what the candlesticks do, they give you a psychological aspect of what the market is doing. Because of course, you know, a big long candle like this one, this was a very strong bearish momentum, sentimentally speaking. Remember, we are talking on sentiment analysis. So a big bear candle like this one is a very strong indication that this was strong momentum. So a big bull, of course, like this one was a very strong bullish momentum. So right now on weekly, what I'm seeing, pound seems to have found a strong area of support right now on the 200 moving average. So right now, pound seems to be changing sentiment. So let's see on, so what you do, first you look at weekly, no, we start with monthly. Then look at the candle that's forming, then also establish your areas of support or resistance. So on monthly, of course, our strong support should be around this area. It's a zone, remember, not the price, but it's a zone around this area where you can see, yeah, where you can see these wicks forming, because this usually we call them rejection spikes, when basically the buyers, the sellers tried to push the price further, but the buyers came in very strong. So this move or this indication was indication of presence of very strong buyers, or the bulls were coming in strongly. So this is my monthly chart on the cable. So I'm trailing it. So right now I think cable can go long, because we can see this level has been tested almost one, two and three times. So cable, this is on monthly, might go long. I'm still not sure. So for me to confirm, I'll have to go to my shorter time frames. And there's usually something I know out there, guys, you know, called multiple time frame analysis. When you use multiple time frame analysis, you're able to understand better what is happening. The only challenge I have with the cable is the Brexit, because they have not been able to come up with any, formidable agreement with the EU. So it's been really losing. So let's check on you can see, this is my weekly time frame. So you can see on my monthly, this is my strong support. But when I come to my weekly, yeah, it seems to be almost the same. But this is when the market makers, of course, came in, they had to dip it, then come back in. Of course, this is where most accounts are lost, because this kind of move usually happens quite often. So let's also check it on D1. So you can see on D1, it seems to be a very strong bullish momentum. So I'm still long, even on my live, I'm still very much long on the cable. because right now I'm not looking at monthly or weekly. I'm looking at the recovery plan. I'm looking at the vaccines. I think US has ordered Moderna for 100 million of doses of vaccine. Russia registered their first vaccine. So everyone is rushing. So right now, of course, COVID is still out there, guys, you need to be safe, but for economies and for governments, they need to come up with a plan to get the economies back on track or to get the people back to work, and of course, the economy and money flowing. But on H4, this is D1. So D1, you can see there was a strong momentum and it broke the 200. Remember, 200 is the one that is my guide on sentiment. Then I'll use H4. Let's see where the 200 is. Yeah, you can see. So H4 can clearly now shows you that sentiment was able to change. It changed around this area. So when did it change? Let me zoom it out again. Yeah. So this is how I'm clearly able to see. You can see it broke, went down up to, let's see, from when it broke here, cable dipped. This was now when? You can see this was exactly March. So you also need to be able to always check the dates. So this was around March this year. Remember that was the lockdown, everything that was happening. Of course, this was the sell-off, all the futures, everything was selling off 1,650 pips. And then now the recovery plan was here from this area. There was a good recovery, 1,000 pips. Then it went up again up to 1,178 pips. Then there was consolidation. You can see consolidation. Then our levels were being tested, 1, 2, 3, 4. There was almost 4 times. So more than 3 times, of course, there was a big move. So of course, our buy or us going long was around this area. That was 982 pips. So that is cable. So cable, for me, sentiment speaking, I don't think it might change much. So how about the recession news in Britain that came out a few weeks? Aren't we going to see the impact, the huge sale of the cable? Grace, that's a good question. But I need you to understand, let me zoom in cable. Let me use the line chart because we said the line chart is able to show us exactly the sentiment of this pair. So the big sell-off, okay, for there are news that really affect the pair big time. And there are news that might not affect. So for this year, most economies are reporting a negative in GDP because the Q2 especially, that was January, February, March, between March, April, May, June. So between April, May, and June, the Q2, most of them reported negative return because it was basically COVID, lockdown, everything that happened. So they were expecting, of course, by the end of the year, there'll be a contraction of there'll be a recession on the economy. And that is normal because no jobs, COVID, and all the problems facing Brexit, so much. But now investors are always looking at sentiment in a way that, can we get a better news? Like, is there something positive that come out? And one thing, because this sentiment was COVID, this was COVID that hit this sentiment on pound, futures, SP 500, all of them. So the recovery plan was, we need to get back. So that's why pound was gaining. So now the other fundamentals like the recession, that might affect, but not this kind of sell-off. It might be a small sell, but not a big sell-off. So you need to understand the impact of how far the news or how big the news affect there. So the big major news, number one is the interest rates. You have seen the dollar dipped almost how many? 1,040 pips. Another big major news that really affect the sentiment is politics. We have elections on the US coming. Politics, that one is big one. A referendum, I've shown you what Brexit did. Brexit hit down almost 1,000 and I went down again 1,000 pips. So on Brexit alone, cable lost almost 2,000. So I need you to understand every time the market dips or every time the market shoots down like this area, it has to recover. So and most likely it will recover with the same impact that it fell. So you can see here, it fell almost 1,636 pips. Oh yeah, guys are still coming in, welcome. So when it fell this much down, that is to mean that the same momentum that it was able to fall will be the same momentum that it will be able to recover. So let's see the recovery. So the recovery was from here, at least the first recovery was here before it was able to retrace that 950. But the main recovery was at least 11, 1,011 pips. This is 1,014. 1,114 pips, sorry. 1,114 pips. It has to always get to a peak like this one, before it tries to dip down. Then you can see it touched our level of support a little bit. Then the price bounced back again. Then there was a small, going down. Then it almost dipped again. Then now it was ranging within our zone. So you can see it would go up, then come down. Again, hit our level of support. Then once it hits now, now we are able to know. So you can see there was a formation of that KW I was telling you. You have to always look at the pattern formations. I'm going to explain to you that later as we continue. It was able to dip, then it was able to keep going up again. So as at the moment, cable, as we look at it, where it is line chart or candlestick, we are still very strong as a bull. So for us to be able to measure where we are going, we will use an oscillator. So there's an oscillator usually called RSI. So let me add RSI. It's usually very, very relative strength index. So when I'm going to just add the relative strength index, but I'm going to add 50. You can see I have level 30, 70, and 50. So the idea is I need to know how far is this market going. So right now on H4, you can see we are ranging within the 50 mark. So that's why right now I think we are arranging, because we need the market to cross, or we need RSI at least to cross 50 for us to keep trending up. On D1, you can see it seems to be still ranging, but it seems to be curving up. It's the moment it crosses 50, the sentiment changes. If it keeps going above 50, the sentiment remains the same. Let's check it on weekly. So yeah, on weekly it's still a bit flat. So you can see RSI is a little bit flat, but it's above 50. So that's why I'm telling you both weekly. Let's also check it on monthly. Yeah, monthly now, that's why you can see it has already crossed the 50. So for me, I think I'll still remain bullish. I'll be long on cable because my sentiment here on above 50 still showing me what is happening. But I'll also be checking it on a weekly, daily time frame. So I'm looking at H1, H4 to basically track how far we're going. So this is GBPUSD. So let's go back on Brexit. So because Brexit is still a stalemate as we speak, nothing has been happening. Everyone is playing hard. So this is Brexit. Let me show you. Where is Brexit? Yeah. So this is Brexit. This is when Brexit happened, guys. Can you see the big candle? So remember, I'm using a longer time frame, weekly time frame. So Brexit was here. This long candle, this week, you see, then from here up to here, this was the Brexit. So it dipped 1,825 pips. Then of course it went down all the way to, let me tell you, Brexit hit up to 2,868. I'm telling you guys, we made good money. I was just selling, because Brexit was bad for UK. They're leaving the EU. The European Union is the biggest market in the whole world, with over, I think, 20 or 21 trillion USD in terms of business deals. So UK getting out meant they have to be on their own. The biggest financial firms, HSBC, Barclays, all of them, they are based in London. London is the biggest financial hub in the world. So you can imagine now, business would for them leaving, that means it's hard to business. Movement is also a problem. So that news automatically, sentiment speaking, I knew it was bad news. So that's why cable was able to dip. So you can see it dipped almost 2,000. This was a lot. So this was almost 2,855 pips. But as I've told you, there has to always be, of course, consolidation. You can see again within our zone. And then after that happens, you can always look to go long for the recovery. And you see the recovery was back to 2,125. So this was when I think they signed the article, this article 50, the one that was now starting the process of a smooth transition out of the EU. But then of course it's politics, and you guys have, you know how politics works, it's usually messy. Sometimes they agree, sometimes they don't agree. So I'm seeing another question. Brexit conclusion will be known by the end of the year. Time period according to the agreement will lapse from January 21st, then they are out of the EU. Yeah, true. So for Brexit, we'll still be waiting for the talks. So that is on pound. I really love trading the cable. So out there, if you're trading, pound is one of my favorites. with the dollar. So because sentimentally speaking, it's able to obey all the rules. So when you understand its sentiment and you're also able to combine with the fundamentals and your technical outlook, depending with your strategy, you're able to come up with a very, very good trading opportunities. So I think that's pound. Any other? I think I've handled pound on Brexit. I've handled the dollar. We have gone back to 2008. What happened? The financial crash. We're able to see what happened, sentiment speaking. What we're also able to check on the euro. And then there's also gold. Let me also check gold. And then let me finish up at least with the gold. So gold is also another big deal, because now the thing with gold, let me add it up back to our chart, because I want us just to use the same chart. So let me pull out gold here. So XAU, so this is gold. It's at 1925, 1926. So for gold, now the same thing that happened. So now gold is number one. It never loses its intrinsic value. Number two, gold is also has never lost its monetary value since, you know, 5,000 years ago BC. They were still using gold coins. So gold is one of the most precious metals. So 2008, when the Nini happened, so this is gold on weekly. So let me show you. This is 2007. So let's use the line chart again, because I'm able to track better. So this was 2008. This was around September, July, that was 6th to 7th. So this was around 6th here. So this point, when the crash happened, gold dipped around how many pips? 2,411 pips. That's how much gold dipped. But then remember, all the currencies were going down because it was a crash. It was the whole market. The bubble happened. I'll give you guys a movie, a good movie to watch. It's called The Big Short, and also look for The Inside Job. Basically, it explained the whole 2008 scenario and what went down. So when it dipped, then now it gained. Look, guys, it gained almost 3,000 pips. Actually, not 3,000, 11,220 pips. So that is within a period of, this was 2008 up to 2011. So how many years were those? Around 3 years, right? Yeah, three. Within 3 years, it was able to rise up or regain almost 11,534 pips. So gold is a big deal. COVID situation, let's look at this year. Now, why did that happen? Because gold is usually considered as a safe haven. In case of market turmoil, in case of financial crashes, in case anything bad is happening, basically. Bad means big time, like a financial crash, like COVID this year. Gold, I think this year, let's check how much it has gained, because of course, investors are always looking to go or to rush for a safe haven. So let's see 2020, what gold has done. So this has been gold since 2020. Sentiment speaking was from here. Where is 20? So think 2020, 05 January 2020 started around this area. So gold had started rising. Then around March, the same, February 20th, 23rd, when lockdown was happening, gold dipped around 1,729 pips. Because of course, also the S&P and everyone, there was the big sell-off and the crash. Oil turned negative. You guys know that, because there was nobody buying. Everyone is locked down, cars, airplanes. Suppliers had to pay people to take off oil their hands. They had to spill 2 million barrels of oil for to create demand, basically. So, of course, everything went down. But gold just dipped. But then it regained again up to 5,000. Wow, this is a lot. 5,366 pips. So between, this was when? Let's see. So as I've told you, always check the dates. So this was exactly 15th of March. Now look, exactly the same time they cut the interest rates was exactly the same time gold started rising. Like it rose, this was, you also check the price, this was exactly around 1494 price. So from 1494, it went up to 2034. So hey, that's a lot. So that was exactly how many pips. So if you calculate, this was exactly 5,326 pips. So, and as at the moment, let's check the sentiment. So this is on weekly. So let me zoom in. So let me go back to the candlesticks. So right now, I think gold might be ranging, because you can see there's some, there seems to be, it seems to has to have rejected 2016 price on our downward. So all you do is just go back to the line chart. So you can see the rejection was a curve on the downside. So right now, I can't tell you to buy gold yet, because you can see on weekly, it seems to be falling. Also check you can see your RSI, gold seems to be leaving 70. So this was our overbought price. So it hit its all-time high. It also broke its resistance on 2011. So I think, let's see, what was our, yeah, you can see this was our resistance. In 2011, our main resistance was around this area. This was which price? Price was 1881. So 1881 was our main price in 2011, and it broke to go to almost 2034 or 2037. So basically right now, gold, now we do this, we go back to our candlesticks, we go now to a lower time frame on D1, there's a lot of consolidation happening. So you can see, and also you can see RSI seems to be crossing. So the moment RSI starts crossing 50, of course we'll be going short on gold. So on H4, the same. So on H4 now, our main resistance. So for me to track gold, I'll just track it weekly. And then of course I'll put my separators. So let me add my separators. Sorry guys. A minute guys. So 1 minute guys, just hold on. Philip, Carol, someone talk to the person on chat. So, oh, sorry guys. So we were at gold, so our work office. So I was saying, so for me right now, I'm tracking it let me remove the grids. So this is how I'm tracking gold right now at 1926 with 200, of course. And also RSI. So gold right now, we are more of ranging up, down momentum. So we need this kind of momentum. Can you see all this kind of momentum? If we are going to sell, we need this. If we are going to buy, we need this. So what we do now, we wait, we usually wait for a breakout or a bounce. So either the price will break 200 or go up. So my main person, or the main indicator that shows me my sentiment, I really rely so much on RSI. 70 is your overbought, 30 is your oversold, 50 is your ranging or your neutral pattern. So mostly, of course, I'm using H4 or I'm using D1. So D1 usually is my main guide, because you can see, let me show you when it started rising. It was exactly here, it formed a little W. Then you can see this was when the sell-off happened. So it bounced back up. So there was no break, because you can see this is where it bounced back up. And where it was bouncing, it was exactly when RSI crossed 50 above. Then you can see it couldn't cross 50 again. You can see all the way it tried to dip back, then came back again above 50. So you can see since then, sentiment speaking, it has never gone back. So we wait. So for me, out there, gold, look on it on D1 and look on it on RSI. So it has to cross or it has to bounce. If it bounces, we will go long. If it crosses going down, of course, we'll be going short. So I think that's the end of my presentation. The W, the M's, that's for another day. It's more on technical. So today we are mostly talking on sentiment analysis. So I think for now I can call it a day, unless guys I have any questions. I've given you enough, almost two hours. So unless there are no more questions, I think I've recorded this whole session. So guys, you'll be able to check it on YouTube. And thanks guys for giving me the time to be able to give you more on sentiment analysis. Good job, man. Yeah, thanks so much, Senpai out there. And everyone else, I want to encourage you guys, come on board. We are here at Gemini. You have our subgroups, you have my number out there. We're waiting. I want to help as many as possible to be able to make some good money in Forex, and of course to be financially independent. So for now, I think I'll end my presentation, and until next time, that's